In this class, I will be explaining about operational amplifier. Before going into detail, what are the topics to be covered in operational amplifier? Let us know how it got its name, operational amplifier. So, it's very clear, the operational amplifier, also known as op-amp, is a versatile device that can be used to amplify DC as well as AC input signals. It's a versatile device because it can amplify DC as well as AC input signals, and was originally designed for computing mathematical functions such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, integration. So as it's doing computing mathematical function, it has got the name operational amplifier. In short, we call it as op-amp. Okay, so it's clear, operational amplifier, due to computing mathematical functions, it got its name, and it's a versatile device which can be used to amplify DC as well as AC input signals. So what is the operational amplifier can do along with this computing mathematical functions? With the addition of suitable external feedback components, the op-amp can be used for a variety of applications such as AC and DC signals, amplification, active filters, oscillators, comparators, regulators, etc. So, along with the computing mathematical functions, it can be used to amplify AC and DC signals, active filters. It can also be used as oscillator, comparator, regulator, and other applications. So, in this class, we'll be saying the following topics. Topics to be covered are block diagram of a typical op-amp, define schematic symbol, definition of an operational amplifier, schematic symbol of an op-amp, pin diagram of LM741C, equivalent circuit of an op-amp, ideal voltage transfer curve, characteristics of op-amp, characteristics of an ideal op-amp, open loop configuration, and deriving the gain equation capital A. Capital A is known as open loop gain. The next topic is, what is the need of closed loop op-amp configuration? And then about inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier with feedback, and deriving the gain equation AF. So the gain equation in open loop is designated by capital A, and gain with feedback is denoted by AF. The next concept is virtual ground, and the applications of inverting amplifier with feedback is current to voltage converter, and the next topic is voltage follower. So these are the topics which we are going to cover in this class. Okay, let us start with the first topic, block diagram of an operational amplifier, the block diagram of an op-amp. So op-amp is having four blocks: input stage, intermediate stage, level shifting stage, and output stage. Okay, so there are four blocks in this block diagram: input stage, intermediate stage, level shifting stage, and output stage. There are two inputs, non-inverting input and inverting input, and single output. So an op-amp is a two input, is having two input and one output. So first stage, the input stage, is known as dual input balanced output differential amplifier. So the input stage is comprising of dual input balanced output differential amplifier. So dual input means two inputs are coming balanced, so it's having two outputs going. So input stage is a dual input balanced output differential amplifier. What this stage is doing? The input stage is providing most of the voltage gain of the operational amplifier. It provides most of the gain of the op amp and also establishes the input resistance of the op amp. So it's providing most of the voltage gain and input resistance of the op amp. The second stage is the intermediate stage. The intermediate stage is comprising of dual input unbalanced output differential amplifier. So here it is a dual input and single output. So it is known as unbalanced output differential amplifier. So intermediate stage is comprising of dual input unbalanced output differential amplifier. The intermediate stage is driven by the output of the first stage. Okay, so it is driven, the output of input stage is given as input to the intermediate stage. The third stage is known as level shifting stage, also known as level translator. It's comprising of an emitter follower. So the level shifting circuit is used after the intermediate stage to shift the DC level at the output of intermediate stage to 0 volts. So what is happening? The output, the DC level of the intermediate stage is shifted to 0 volts with the help of level shifting stage. So I repeat the working of level shifting stage. The level translator or shifting circuit is used after the intermediate stage to shift the DC level at the output of intermediate stage to 0 volts with respect to ground. It's comprising of an emitter follower or CC common collector configuration circuit. And the output stage is comprising of complementary symmetry push-pull amplifier. So what is this output stage doing? The output stage increases the output voltage swing and increases the current supplying capability of the op amp. It increases the output voltage swing and increases the current supplying capability of the op amp. So this is the block diagram of an operational amplifier or op amp, comprising of input stage, intermediate stage, level shifting stage and output stage. There are two inputs, one output. Dual input balanced output differential amplifier, dual input unbalanced output differential amplifier, emitter follower, complementary symmetry push-pull amplifier. It provides most of the voltage gain of the amplifier and establishes the input resistance of the op amp, and it is driven by the input stage to bring the DC level of the intermediate stage to zero level. Level shifting stage is used and output stage is used to increase the output voltage swing and increases the current supplying capability of the op amp. I hope the block diagram is clear with four stages of an op amp. Let us now move to the definition of op amp. Once you are clear with the block diagram, the definition is based on the block diagram. The definition of operational amplifier is, an operational amplifier is a direct coupled high gain amplifier. It's a high gain amplifier, usually consisting of one or more differential amplifier followed by a level translator and an output stage. The output stage is generally a push-pull or a push-pull complementary symmetry pair. So this definition is based on the block diagram which we have seen now, this diagram. So what is the op-amp definition? An operational amplifier is a direct coupled high gain amplifier usually consisting of one or more differential amplifier followed by a level translator and an output stage. The output stage is generally a push-pull or a push-pull complementary symmetry pair. Now, how op-amp is available? An op-amp is available as a single IC package. It's available as a single IC package. IC stands for integrated circuit. So, its op-amp is available to us in an IC form. What are the applications of op-amp? It is used for AC, DC signal amplification. It's used for active filters, comparators, regulators and other applications. Coming to the schematic symbol of op-amp. This is a schematic symbol of the op-amp. We have seen the block diagram. So, we can't draw so big block diagram or circuit diagram when we are doing the analysis of op-amp. So, we need to use the schematic symbol, which is very easy to draw and is useful for doing the analysis of an op-amp for the derivation of gain of the op-amp. So, op-amp is having two inputs, inverting input, non-inverting input. Inverting input is shown by minus sign and non-inverting input is shown by plus sign. And this A is a large signal gain of the op-amp. As it is having cascaded differential amplifier, so its gain is very large. So, it is represented by capital A. And it is having single output, which is denoted by V naught. So, the op-amp is having two inputs, V1, V2. V1 is the voltage at non-inverting input. It is in volts. V2. What is V2? Voltage at inverting input in volts. V0. V0 is the output voltage in volts. A is a large signal voltage gain. This is the schematic symbol for an op-amp. Next, coming to the pin diagram of LM741C. The most commonly used op-amp is this one, LM741C. So, in this one, we will first understand what is the significance of this LM. So, the first two letters of this number indicates the manufacturer name. LM is giving the ordering information. So, this is LM741C. This information is for ordering. So, LM is for National Semiconductor. 741 is the IC number and C indicates that this IC is used for commercial purpose. So, it is made of National Semiconductor. It is made by National Semiconductor Manufacturer. Okay, coming to the pin diagram, the LM741 is a 8-pin IC. Is a 8-pin IC. So, you have to start the numbering from this notch. Then the pin nearer to the notch will be numbered as 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, 1 to 8 pins are numbered. And here, first pin is minus offset null. And 2 is minus inverting input. 3 is non-inverting input. 4 is minus V. So, at 4 we are connecting the DC supply. And 5 is offset null. So, 1 is minus offset null and 5 is plus offset null. 6th is output. So, the input are 2 and 3, inverting, non-inverting and 6th is the output pin. 7th is plus V. Plus V means plus VCC is connected. So, minus 4 is for minus VCC and 7 is for plus VCC. 8th pin is NC, not connected. So, LM741C is a 8-pin IC where 2 and 3 are the input, 6 is the output pin. At 4 and 7 we are connecting the DC supply, minus VCC, plus VCC. 1 is minus offset null and 5 is plus offset null and 8 pin is not connected. So, pin 2 is what now? Inverting input. Pin 3 is non-inverting input, and pin 6 is output pin. So by this we complete the definition, schematic and pin diagram. Now let us see the equivalent circuit of the op amp. The equivalent circuit is useful in analyzing the basic operating principles of op amp and in observing the effects of feedback arrangement. So with the help of this equivalent circuit, we can do analysis for basic operating principles of the op amp. So let us see the equivalent circuit. A triangle, inside the triangle we are having equivalent resistance Ri, input resistance, R naught is output resistance, and here a voltage source is there which is AVID. It is having two inputs. V1 is a non-inverting input, V2 is a inverting input. V1, V2 are the inputs and V0 is the output. Minus VEE plus VCC. So, two DC supplies are given to this op amp. Internally, it is having an input resistance Ri, input resistance and output resistance R0 and a voltage AVID. So, what is the basic equation of an op amp? So, what is this op amp doing? It is amplifying the difference of two input signals. So, here it is V1 and this is V2. So, what is VID? VID is equal to V1 minus V2. So, the basic output equation will be, what is op amp doing? Op amp is amplifying the input. Okay. So, here this is V0 and here it is VID, V1, V2. So, what is input to this op amp? VID. So, this VID is amplified A times to get the output voltage, that is known as basic op amp equation. So, what is the output voltage of an op amp? A times of VID. What is VID? Differential input voltage or difference input voltage. So, basic op amp equation is V0 is equal to AVID, where A is a large signal voltage gain and VID is a difference input voltage. V1 is voltage at, V1 is voltage at non-inverting input terminal with respect to ground, and V2 is a voltage at inverting terminal, minus terminal of the op amp with respect to the ground. Okay. So, how to draw the equivalent circuit of an ideal op amp? So, an op amp, ideal op amp equivalent circuit and practical op amp. So, in ideal condition, the input resistance is ideally infinity. Ri is infinity. Ri is infinity means it is open circuited. Ri is infinity. And R0 is 0. R0 is 0 means resistance is 0. So, it is shown by a short circuit here. R0 is short circuited. Ri is infinity, so it is shown by open circuited. So, in equivalent circuit, Ri is made open circuited and R0 is short circuited. Okay, so in V1, V2 and output is V0. For an ideal op amp. For coming to practical op amp, connect Ri, R0, AVID. Inputs are V1, V2 and output is V0. What is the output equation of op amp? It is A times of VID. VID is a difference of two input voltages, V1 minus V2. Okay, so Ri is infinity, so open circuit, R0 is 0, so short circuit. This is ideal op amp equivalent circuit and this is a practical op amp circuit. Coming to the ideal voltage transfer curve, it's a transfer curve between VID versus V0, differential input voltage, difference input voltage versus output voltage. The transfer curve is a graphical representation of V naught is equal to VID. V naught is equal to VID, where output voltage V naught is plotted against the difference input voltage, where V naught is plotted against difference input voltage VID by keeping a constant. Why it is known as idle? Because the output offset voltage is assumed to be zero. We are assuming that the output offset voltage is zero. So it's a graph between V naught versus VID by keeping the gain constant. So what happens? Till certain value, it's showing a linear graph. It means V naught is directly proportional to VID. When it reaches to the saturation value, then output becomes constant. The output becomes constant. So when the output reaches to a saturation value, the output becomes constant. So it is known as plus V sat and it is minus V sat. So idle voltage transfer curve is defined as graphical representation of output voltage versus input difference voltage VID by keeping the gain constant. The basic op amp equation is V naught is equal to A times of VID. Okay. Now let us see the characteristics of op amp. Characteristics, the first characteristics of op amp is the input offset voltage VIO is the voltage that must be applied between the two input terminals of the op amp to null the output. So what is input offset voltage? The voltage that must be applied between two input terminals of the op amp to null the output. We have to null the output. So it is symbolically written as VIO. Okay. So how the input offset voltage is the voltage that must be applied between the two input terminals of the op amp to null the output, to make the output voltage zero, is known as input offset voltage VIO. Next one is input offset current. It is the algebraic difference between the currents into the inverting and non-inverting terminal is referred as input offset current. Is the algebraic difference. When we have applied no input to the op amp, let us say the current flowing at non-inverting is IB1, the current flowing at minus is IB2. So the algebraic difference between IB1 and IB2 is known as input offset current. IB1 is the current into the non-inverting terminal, IB2 is the current into the inverting terminal. So when we take the algebraic difference of these two currents, it is known as input offset current IIO. Next definition is, next characteristics is input bias current. So IB1 is the current into the non-inverting input, IB2 is the current into the inverting input. So the average of the current that flows into the inverting and non-inverting terminal of the op amp is known as input bias current. Okay, the average of the currents. Input resistance RI is a differential input resistance, is the equivalent resistance that can be measured at either inverting or non-inverting input terminal with other terminal connected to ground. So, what is equivalent resistance measured at either inverting or non-inverting with other terminal connected to ground is known as input resistance. Next characteristics is large signal voltage gain. Gain means what? Output by input. So, for an op-amp, there are two inputs and the gain is A. Inputs are V1, V2 and output is V0 plus minus. What is the input here? VID. So, what is output here? V0. Output voltage by differential input voltage VID. So, large signal gain is output by input. Output is V0, input is VID. V0 is output voltage, VID is differential input voltage. A is large signal voltage gain. Next characteristics is output resistance. Output resistance R0 is the equivalent resistance that can be measured between the output terminal of the op-amp and the ground. Okay. Equivalent resistance and can be measured between the output terminal of the op-amp and ground. Next characteristics is common mode rejection ratio. Is a ratio of differential voltage gain AD to the common mode voltage gain ACM. CMRR is equal to differential voltage gain by common mode voltage gain AD by ACM. Okay, so let us see what is ACM. When we are giving same common input voltage to both the terminals, plus means non-inverting terminal, minus is inverting terminal. When a common inputs VCM is given to both the terminals of the op-amp, then we say the op-amp is working in common mode configuration. Here VCM, common mode voltage, is plus 13 volts is given common to both input voltage. So, we say this op-amp is working in common mode configuration. Okay, so what is ACM? A is gain. Gain means output by input. Gain in common mode is equal to output in common mode by input in common mode. Okay. So, what is AD? Differential gain. What is differential gain? AD is equal to A. That is VID is input and V0 is output. V1, V2. Okay, so differential gain is also known as simply A. A is equal to V0 by VID. ACM is equal to VOCM by VCM. Common mode voltage gain. Differential mode gain. So, CMRR is differential voltage gain to the common mode voltage gain. Okay. CMRR is equal to AD by ACM, differential voltage gain by common mode voltage gain. Next characteristics is slew rate. Slew rate is defined as maximum rate of change of output voltage per unit time, dV0 by dt, maximum rate of change of output voltage per unit time. Its unit is volts per microseconds. Next characteristics is gain bandwidth product, GB. Gain bandwidth product is the bandwidth of the op-amp when the voltage gain is 1. Bandwidth is what? Range of frequencies which are allowed to pass through an op-amp. So, these are the characteristics of op-amp. What are the characteristics? Input offset voltage VIO, input offset current IIO, input bias current IB, input resistance, output resistance, large signal voltage gain, CMRR, slew rate, gain bandwidth, product. Next topic is characteristics of ideal op amp. The first point is infinite voltage gain, A is equal to infinity. An ideal op amp has infinite voltage gain, A is infinity. Infinite input resistance, Ri is infinity, so that it can drive any number of signal sources. So that any signal source can drive it and there is no loading of the preceding stage. Infinite input resistance Ri so that any signal source can drive it and there is no loading of the preceding stage. Third characteristics is zero output resistance R0 so that output can drive an infinite number of other devices. Op amp can drive an infinite number of other devices. So R0, the output resistance is ideally zero. R0 is zero. Fourth point is zero output voltage when the input voltage is zero. When the input voltage Vi is zero, output voltage is also zero. Infinite bandwidth so that any frequency signal from zero to infinity hertz can be amplified without attenuation. Next is infinite CMRR, infinite common mode rejection ratio, so that common mode noise is zero. What is CMRR definition? CMRR is equal to differential gain by common mode gain. And what is this common mode gain? Common mode gain is output in common mode by input in common mode. So how this gain is coming? What is common? Some noise or unwanted signal. So when the common mode noise is zero, when the common mode noise is zero, what happens? This ACM becomes zero. So CMRR will be infinity. So CMRR should be ideally infinity so that the common mode noise voltage is zero. Infinite slew rate. What is the slew rate? Slew rate is defined as maximum rate of change of output voltage with respect to time. Okay, so how much it should be? It should be infinite, infinite slew rate so that output voltage changes simultaneously with respect to the input voltage change. So here we have seen 7 points of characteristics of an ideal op amp, which we can summarize it in a table here. A summary table of ideal op amp characteristics and practical op amp 741C values are tabulated here. For an ideal op amp, large signal gain A is infinity, input resistance is infinity, R0 resistance is zero, R output resistance is zero, bandwidth is infinity, CMRR is infinity, slew rate is infinity. So if you look at this 3-6 characteristics for an ideal op amp, all are infinity except the output resistance. Output resistance is zero. Gain, input resistance, bandwidth, CMRR, slew rate, these are infinity. And output resistance is zero. The output resistance is low or zero so that it can drive an infinite number of other devices. CMRR is infinity because the common mode noise voltage is zero. So coming to practical op amp 741C, A value is 2 lakhs. Input resistance value is 2 mega ohms. Output resistance is low of the value 75 ohms. Bandwidth of 741C is 1 megahertz. CMRR value is 90 dB. Decibels, dB stands for decibels. And slew rate is 0.5 volts per microsecond. So this is a summary of an ideal op amp and practical op amp. Gain, input resistance, bandwidth, CMRR, slew rate are infinity and output resistance is zero and very low. Okay, so now let us see how we can use this op amp. Op amp can be connected in open loop configuration or in closed loop configuration. This is a schematic symbol we have seen. For the ease of analysis of the op amp, we use the symbol in the circuit diagram. Plus means non-inverting terminal, minus means inverting terminal. So op amp is having two input terminals and one output terminal. V1 is the voltage at non-inverting terminal, V2 is the voltage at inverting terminal of the op amp, and V0 is the output voltage. A is a large signal gain of the op amp. So op amp was initially used for mathematical computation, but later on with the addition of some feedback element, it is now used for variety of applications like filters, regulators and so on. So it's very clear the op amp can be connected in two ways: open loop op amp and closed loop op amp. So there is a few comparison points for open loop op amp and closed loop op amp. Used as the open loop op amp is used as a high gain amplifier, and closed loop op amps are used as high gain amplifier, inverter, voltage to current converter and so on. In open loop op amp, there is no connection between output and input, either directly or via another network. In closed loop op amp, when a part of output is fed back to the input, we say either by direct or via any network, it is known as closed loop op amp. Okay, so in open loop op amp, there is no feedback between output and input, and in closed loop op amp there is feedback. Coming to open loop configuration, an op amp without feedback is called as open loop amplifier or amplifier without feedback. An op amp that uses feedback, that is there is a connection between output and input, is known as feedback amplifier or closed loop amplifier. So open loop amplifier or amplifier without feedback, and closed loop amplifier is also known as feedback amplifier. Okay, so now let us derive the gain equation of open loop configuration, open loop op amp configuration. So the open loop op amp configuration, other name is op amp without feedback. So op amp can be connected in three configurations in open loop. Open loop means there is no connection between output back to the input. So in open loop op amp configuration, there are three methods of connecting: differential amplifier mode, inverting amplifier mode and non-inverting amplifier mode. These are the three configurations. In the first configuration, the differential amplifier mode, in this configuration, we are connecting two input signals, V in 1, V in 2. V in 1 is connected to the plus terminal, that is to the non-inverting terminal of the op amp, and V in 2 is connected to the minus or negative terminal, or known as inverting terminal of the op amp. So the input of the op amp is what? VID. What is VID? V1 minus V2. It's having an op amp schematic symbol, plus minus, two inputs and one output, and two DC supplies, minus VEE plus VCC, and across RL we are observing the output voltage. It is known as differential amplifier because we are connecting two input signal sources, V in 1 and V in 2, and it is amplifying the difference of two input signals. So it is known as differential amplifier. So the op amp basic equation, we know V naught is equal to A times of VID. V0 is equal to A times of VID, and VID is what? V1 minus V2. A, V1 minus V2. What is V1 value? V1 value is V in 1. V2 value is how much? V in 2. That we have substituted. So the output voltage equation of the differential amplifier in open loop configuration is V naught is equal to A times of V in 1 minus V in 2. Okay, so the op amp amplifies the difference between the two input signals. This configuration is called differential amplifier. The op amp is a versatile device because it amplifies both AC and DC input signals. This means that this V in 1 and V in 2 can either be AC or DC signals. Both can be either AC or both can be both DC signals. Next configuration is inverting amplifier. In inverting amplifier, only a single input is used. The input signal source V in is connected at minus terminal of the op amp and non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground. Okay, so in inverting terminal V in is connected to minus or inverting terminal of the op amp, so it is known as inverting amplifier. So VID is the input difference input voltage, V naught is the output difference output voltage. The basic op amp equation V naught is equal to A times of VID. And what is VID? V1 minus V2. V naught is equal to A times of V1 minus V2. V1 voltage is 0 as it's connected to ground. So V1 is 0. V2 is Vin. So after substituting V1 as 0, V2 as Vin, we got V naught is equal to minus A times of Vin. Okay, in inverting amplifier, this output voltage equation V naught is equal to minus A times of Vin. Okay, so the inverting amplifier amplifies the input signal Vin by gain A, and it is inverted at the output. This minus sign indicates that input is inverted at the output. In inverting amplifier, only one input is applied at the inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal is grounded. Non-inverting amplifier. So, the non-inverting amplifier is also a single input amplifier. The input Vin is connected to plus terminal of the op amp and minus terminal, that is inverting terminal, is connected to ground, and V naught is the output voltage. So, what is the basic equation of op amp? V naught is equal to A times of VID. VID is equal to V1 minus V2. V1 value is Vin and V2 value is 0 because it's connected to ground. So, V1 is Vin minus 0. So, output voltage is coming to be as A times of Vin. In non-inverting amplifier, the output is larger than input voltage by gain A and is in phase with the input signal. Both output and input are in phase because it's plus, whereas coming to inverting amplifier it is minus. So output and input are out of phase. Input is applied to the non-inverting terminal and inverting terminal is connected to ground. So, we can connect op amp in open loop in three configurations: differential amplifier having two inputs, inverting amplifier input is connected to minus terminal, and in non-inverting terminal input Vin is connected to plus terminal of the op amp. So, the op amp in open loop, there are three configurations: the differential amplifier, inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier. So, let us just quickly see open loop inverting amplifier. So, once again I have revised it. Inverting amplifier means input is connected to minus terminal. The output equation V naught is equal to minus A times of Vin. This is inverting amplifier. The input is of this kind. The output is having a phase reversal. It will be for the positive cycle, it is showing negative cycle, and for negative cycle it is showing positive cycle. It means the inverting amplifier is doing phase reversal. The negative sign indicates that output voltage and input voltage are 180 degree out of phase. Inverting amplifier means input is connected to minus terminal of the op amp and non-inverting terminal is connected to ground. V naught is equal to minus A times of V in. It means output voltage and input voltage are out of phase by 180 degree. This is how we draw 180 degree out of phase waveforms. And coming to non-inverting amplifier, in non-inverting amplifier input is connected to plus terminal of the op amp and in inverting terminal is connected to ground. Its output voltage equation is coming to be as V naught is equal to A times of V in. So for a non-inverting amplifier, if you are giving this input signal, the output is in same phase because V naught is equal to A times because of plus sign. It means both output voltage and input are in same phase. So for positive cycle you are getting plus positive cycle, for negative cycle you are getting negative cycle. Okay. Now let us, after completion of this open loop op amp, the open loop op amp can be connected in three configurations: differential amplifier, inverting and non-inverting amplifier. Now let us see what is the need of closed loop op amp. An op amp that uses feedback is called feedback amplifier. It is also called closed loop amplifier because the feedback forms a closed loop between output and input. So it is known as closed loop amplifier. The open loop amplifier A is very high. Only the smaller signals of the order of microvolts or less, having very low frequency, may be amplified accurately without a distortion. Signals this small are very susceptible to noise and almost impossible to obtain in the laboratories. Okay, so what is the limitation of open loop op amp? Op amp without feedback, that the input what is applied, the gain is very large. A is equal to V naught by VID. So here the input in open loop will be very small, of the order of microvolts or even less. This microvolt signals cannot be amplified accurately without distortion. So these signals, this microvolt input signals, are susceptible to noise and almost impossible to obtain in the laboratory. Next point is the variations in voltage gain are relatively large in open loop op amp, either due to change in temperature, power supply, which makes the open loop op amp unsuitable for many applications. So when op amp is connected in open loop, it is more susceptible to variations in voltage gain. This variations in voltage gain can be due to change in temperature or power supply, which makes the open loop op amp unsuitable for many applications because of the variations in the voltage gain. So one point is the input signal are of the order of microvolts or less, which are susceptible to noise and it's almost impossible to obtain in the laboratory. The second point is variation in voltage gain are also relatively very high in open loop op amp. The next point is the bandwidth of open loop op amp, for example for 74C it is approximately 5 hertz in more almost applications. A bandwidth larger than 5 hertz is needed. So look at this example of the 741C, its bandwidth is 5 Hz. But we, for many applications, we need the bandwidth larger than 5 Hz. So it's also one of the limitation of open loop op amp. The open loop op amp is generally not used in linear applications. By feedback, gain of the op amp can be controlled. Okay, so op amp is generally not used, open loop op amps is not generally used in linear applications. So these are the few limitations of open loop op amp. The first point is the input signals are of the order of microvolts or less, which are susceptible to noise and are almost impossible to obtain in the laboratory. And the variation in the voltage gain are relatively large in open loop op amp due to change in temperature, power supply, which makes unsuitable for many applications. But bandwidth is also very less. It's around 5 Hz for 74C, which is generally for other almost applications, the bandwidth required is larger than 5 Hz. And open loop op amp is generally not suitable in linear applications. So we can control the gain of an op amp by feedback or by closed loop. Now let us derive closed loop op amp configuration gain. So in the last slide we have seen the op amp in open loop can be connected in three configurations: differential amplifier, inverting amplifier, non-inverting amplifier. Now we are going to start closed loop amplifier. Other name of closed loop amplifier is amplifier with feedback or feedback amplifier. In this coming slide, I will be explaining about how to derive the gain, closed loop voltage gain of an inverting amplifier. The other name of inverting amplifier with feedback is voltage shunt feedback amplifier. Other name of inverting amplifier with feedback is voltage shunt feedback amplifier. Why it is known as inverting amplifier with feedback? Let us understand. This is inverting amplifier. Why? Because input Vin is connected to minus terminal of the op amp, and minus terminal of the op amp is known as inverting terminal of the op amp. So when the input is connected to inverting terminal of the op amp and non-inverting terminal is grounded, we say the op amp is connected in inverting mode. And it's a feedback, it's a closed loop, because the output is connected back to the input through the feedback resistor RF. So RF is a feedback element. Okay, so it's an inverting amplifier with feedback. Let us now derive the gain AF for this circuit. So V1 is the voltage at non-inverting terminal, V2 is the voltage at inverting terminal. In applied input voltage is Vin, resistor R1, RF, okay, and minus VEE plus VCC are the DC supply connected to the op amp. A is a large signal gain, and we are observing the output voltage at RL. Inverting amplifier, inverting means input is applied at the minus terminal, so output will be having 180 degree phase shift with respect to input. So the output is written as minus and plus. It's a inverted one. 180 degree phase shift is there. So let us start the derivation of AF. For open loop gain, A is equal to V0 by VID, basic op amp equation. What is the basic op amp equation? V0 is equal to A times of VID. So this A is written as V0 by VID, and VID is equal to V1 minus V2. So we can rewrite this equation here. V1 minus V2 is equal to V0 by A. Okay, Now V1 value is how much here? V1 is 0. V1 is 0. So what we got? V2 is equal to minus V0 by A. So in open loop configuration, we got V2 value as minus V0 by A. Now let us apply KCL at node B. KCL means the current entering is equal to current leaving. The current entering here is IN. The two currents leaving are IB2 and IF, which I have written here. IN is equal to IB2 plus IF. This equation 4. IN is equal to IB2 plus IF. The current entering is equal to sum of the current leaving. Okay. Since RI is very large, RI is input resistance very large, and ideally its value is infinity. So the input bias current IB2, RI is input resistance here. Input resistance here, it's very high. So what will happen to this IB? It will be negligibly, it's a negligible value. Since RI is very large, IB2, what is the name of this IB? Input bias current. This is negligible. So for 741C, RI is 2 mega ohms. And IB will be value will be 0.5 microamperes. Okay, so in this equation, IN IB2 is negligible. So we make IN is approximately equal to IF. IB is neglected. IN is approximately equal to IF. And what is IN? What is IN? If you look at this diagram, IN, V1, VIN, minus V2, I is equal to what? V by R. So I is equal to V by R, V in minus V2 by R1. And what is IF? V2 minus V0 by RF. Okay, that's what is written here. So first we have applied KCL at node B. IN is equal to IB2 plus IF. IB2 is neglected, so we are left with IN is approximated to IF, and I is equal to V by R, which is written as V in minus V2 by R1, and IF is written as V2 minus V0 by RF. So substituting, what is V2 value we got here? V2 value we got it as minus V0 by A. We have to substitute this V2 value here. Vin minus V2, substitute this V2 here. What is the V2 value? Minus V0 by A. So Vin minus V0 by A by R1 is equal to, V2 is equal to minus V0 by A, minus V0 by RF. We have substituted V2 as minus V0 by A. And on simplifying, we will be getting this equation. On rearranging the terms, we can write the ratio of V0 by Vin, which will be coming. What is V0 by Vin? AF. AF is closed loop gain. AF is equal to closed loop gain V0 by Vin, which is coming to be as minus ARF by R1 plus RF by AR1. Okay, so the closed loop gain is AF. AF is equal to V0 by Vin. So on rearranging and writing the ratio of V0 by Vin, we will be getting this minus ARF by R1 plus RF plus AR1. And we know this A value is very large value. A is large signal gain. Ideally, its value is infinity. So we can write this AR1 is very, very large compared to R1 plus RF. Okay, on doing this approximation, what happens? We can neglect these terms and can write R1, this denominator part, R1 plus RF plus AR1 is this becomes approximately very small. So, this denominator is approximated to AR1. So, what is AF? AF is coming to be as V0 by Vin, which is given as minus ARF by AR1. On cancelling A, we are left with minus RF by R1. So, closed loop gain AF equation is coming to be as minus RF by R1. So, this is known as exact equation. Closed loop gain AF is equal to V0 by Vin is equal to minus ARF by R1 plus RF plus AR1. As this is very, very large, this is neglected and we are getting the ideal equation AF is equal to minus RF by R1. The negative sign indicates here that it is an inverting mode, inverting configuration. It means the output and input are 180 degree out of phase. 180 degree out of phase means inverting amplifier. This is input. This is output. So, the input is of this nature. So, output is coming to be as an inverting mode phase reversal. Okay. So, from the ideal gain equation of an inverting amplifier is minus RF by R1. Open loop gain is A is equal to V0 by VID. There are two gains we have seen, open loop gain A is equal to V0 by VID and closed loop gain is V0 by Vin. So, coming to an inverting amplifier, the gain equation is coming to be as minus RF by R1. Next topic is non-inverting amplifier with feedback. Other name of non-inverting amplifier with feedback is voltage series feedback amplifier. Coming to the diagram, the non-inverting amplifier it's known as because we are connecting the input voltage V in to plus terminal. Input signal source is connected to plus or non-inverting terminal of the op amp. So, it is known as non-inverting amplifier, non-inverting mode. And here the output, this is the output pin, the output is connected back to the input through the feedback network R1 and RF. So, as there is a feedback path from output back to the input, it is known as feedback amplifier or a closed loop amplifier. And it is more specifically a non-inverting feedback amplifier. Input is connected at non-inverting terminal and there is a feedback. So, it is known as non-inverting amplifier with feedback. Other name of the circuit is voltage series feedback amplifier. V1 is the voltage at non-inverting terminal, V2 is the voltage at inverting terminal, VID is the difference input voltage which is equal to V1 minus V2 and A is the large signal gain, minus VE plus VCC are the DC voltage applied to the op amp and resistor RF R1 and RF are the feedback element. We are observing the output voltage across the RL and it is in same phase as with the input voltage. In non-inverting amplifier, the output voltage and input voltage both are in phase. Let us now derive the gain equation of this op amp in feedback. So, A is open loop gain and AF is closed loop gain. So, we have to derive what is the closed loop gain of this circuit of the non-inverting amplifier with feedback. So, the closed loop voltage gain is AF. The closed loop voltage gain AF is equal to V0 by Vin, the output voltage by the applied input voltage. So, output is V0, input is Vin. The open loop voltage gain is A. A is equal to V0 by VID. See the difference? AF is the closed loop gain and A is the open loop gain. In closed loop gain, V0 by Vin and A is equal to V0 by VID and VID is equal to V1 minus V2. So, here this writing the V0 equation we have written as V naught is equal to A times of V1 minus V2. And from the figure, V1 is equal to Vin. And V2 is equal to, how much is the V2 value? It is R1 by, apply the voltage divider, R1 by R1 plus RF times the output voltage. How much output voltage you are feeding it back? It is R1 by R1 plus RF times the output voltage. So this V2 is also known as feedback voltage. Okay, so V1 is equal to Vin and V2 is equal to Vf, which is equal to the feedback voltage. How much voltage we are feeding back? R1 by R1 plus RF. Okay, so which is written as, now from this equation 3, V0 is equal to A, V1 minus V2. V1 is equal to Vin and V2 is equal to Vf, which is equal to R1 by R1 plus RF times of V0. On simplifying and rearranging, collecting all the V0 terms together and rearranging and writing the ratio of V0 by Vin, we'll get V0 by Vin is equal to A times of R1 plus RF by R1 plus RF plus AR1, and the ratio V0 by Vin is known as AF. Okay, so how much it is coming? A times of R1 plus RF by R1 plus RF plus AR1, and we know this AR1, this A is very very large value, ideally it is infinity. So, in the denominator part, this AR1 is very very large compared to R1 plus RF. So, we can neglect this R1 plus RF. So, we can write the denominator part R1 plus RF plus AR1 approximated to AR1, because A is a very large value. So, neglecting these terms, we are left with AR1 plus, what we are left with? AF is equal to A times of R1 plus RF by AR1. On cancelling AA, we are left with R1 plus RF by R1, which is written as 1 plus RF by R1. So, this is known as the exact equation of non-inverting amplifier, and it is known as ideal gain equation, which I have summarized it here. So the closed loop gain AF is equal to V0 by Vin, which is equal to A times of R1 plus RF by R1 plus RF plus AR1, exact gain equation. And when after applying the approximation, it becomes an ideal equation. That is, this AR1 is very very large compared to R1 plus RF. So, this term is neglected and we are getting AF, which is equal to output voltage V0 by the applied input voltage Vin, is equal to 1 plus RF by R1, ideal closed loop gain equation. Okay, and non-inverting amplifier with feedback is used in voltage follower. I hope this is understandable to you. And let us summarize the open loop configuration and closed loop configuration gains. Inverting amplifier without feedback. Inverting amplifier without feedback means Vin is applied to minus terminal, inverting terminal, and non-inverting terminal means non-inverting amplifier without feedback. Input is applied to the plus terminal and inverting terminal is grounded. In inverting amplifier without feedback, input is at minus terminal. In non-inverting amplifier without feedback, input is at the plus terminal. Coming to the gain equation, A is equal to minus V0 by Vin for inverting amplifier. For non-inverting amplifier, gain equation is A is equal to V0 by Vin. Okay, next one is coming to closed loop configuration. This is inverting amplifier. why it's inverting, because input is connected to minus terminal of the op amp and there is a feedback path, so it is an inverting amplifier with feedback, and its gain equation is coming to be as AF. In closed loop we give the gain symbol with AF. AF is equal to V naught by V in, which is coming to be as minus ARF by R1 plus RF plus AR1, and this AR1 is very large compared to R1 plus RF, so denominator is approximated to AR1, and hence we get AF is equal to V naught by V in is equal to minus RF by R1. Coming to non-inverting amplifier with feedback, in non-inverting amplifier input is connected to the non-inverting terminal and the feedback network is connected to the inverting terminal of the op amp. So AF is coming to be as V naught by V in, which is coming to be as AR1 plus RF by R1 plus RF by R1 plus RF plus AR1. On approximation, AR1 is very large compared to R1 plus RF, so AF is coming to be as V naught by V in is equal to 1 plus RF by R1. So let us just quickly write all the equations. In open loop, the gain equation is symbolically written as A V naught by VID. Okay, in inverting mode, A equation is coming to be as minus V naught by V in, and in non-inverting mode A is coming to be as V naught by V in. Now coming to closed loop, the gain is represented by AF. AF is coming to be as V naught by V in. Inverting amplifier, AF is coming to be as minus RF by R1. Non-inverting, AF is coming to be as 1 plus RF by R1. These are the four gain equations of open loop op amp and closed loop op amp. So what's the need of closed loop op amp? Because the inputs are in microvolts in open loop, bandwidth is small, and the gain voltage is also fluctuating. So these are the limitations of open loop op amp. So we are going for closed loop op amp. Okay, so we have derived all the four equations. A is equal to minus V naught by V in, non-inverting, A is equal to V naught by V in, AF is equal to minus RF by R1, for non-inverting, AF is equal to 1 plus RF by R1. The general equation in open loop, A is equal to V naught by VID, AF closed loop gain, AF is equal to V naught by V in. Let us now see what is voltage virtual ground. What is virtual ground? Virtual ground is difference input voltage is ideally zero. Ideal op amp gain equation is A is equal to output voltage by differential input voltage, V naught by VID is the basic op amp gain equation, and A ideal A value is infinity. So what happens when A is infinity? VID becomes zero. What is VID? VID is equal to V1 minus V2. Since VID is zero, because A is infinity, VID is zero, so V1 is equal to V2. VID is equal to V1 minus V2, and VID is 0, so V1 it becomes V1 is equal to V2 under ideal condition. What does it mean then? The voltage at non-inverting terminal of op amp is equal to voltage at inverting terminal of the op amp provided that gain is very large. Ideally A is infinity. So what is virtual ground? The voltage at non-inverting terminal is equal to voltage at inverting terminal provided that gain is very large. Ideally A is infinity. Virtual ground concept is used in analysis of closed loop op amps. So virtual ground concept is used for the analysis of closed loop op amp. So what is the concept of virtual ground? Ideally A is infinity, so VID will be 0. VID is 0 means V1 is equal to V2, that is voltage at inverting terminal is equal to voltage at non-inverting terminal. Yes, coming to the next topic, it is current to voltage converter. It is an application of an inverting amplifier with feedback. It's also known as I2V converter, current to voltage converter. It's an application of inverting amplifier with feedback. Let us see the diagram of I2V converter. This is an inverting amplifier. It's an inverting amplifier because input VIN is connected to minus terminal of the op amp or inverting terminal of the op amp, and there is a feedback from output back to the input through this feedback resistor. So it's an inverting amplifier with feedback. So it's a closed loop amplifier. Other name of closed loop amplifier is feedback amplifier, or it is also known as inverting amplifier with feedback. So here input is connected to minus or inverting terminal of the op amp and non-inverting terminal is connected to ground. Now we have to use the circuit as current to voltage converter. So we have replaced this voltage by a current source. It's delivering the current I in. Okay. So other things are common. We have replaced this part by a current source. So now let us see how this circuit is working as current to voltage converter. So as we know, the ideal gain equation of an inverting amplifier is coming to be as AF is equal to V naught by V in, which is coming to be as minus RF by R1. Okay, so now rearranging these terms or multiplying this V in here, we can write the V naught equation as V naught is equal to minus of V in by R1 dot RF. So now this ratio V by R is what? Current I in. And we know virtual ground concept. This virtual ground concept is V1 is equal to V2. V1 is the voltage at non-inverting terminal and V2 is the voltage at inverting terminal. V1 is the voltage at non-inverting terminal and V2 is the voltage at inverting terminal. V1 at plus and V2 is at minus. So what is virtual ground? V1 is equal to V2. By virtual ground, V1 voltage is equal to V2. At a condition when the gain is very large, ideally the gain is infinity. So virtual ground concept is for ideal condition. Since V1 is 0 because it's connected to ground, so what will happen to V2 when V1 is equal to V2 due to virtual ground? V2 will also become 0. So now we have replaced this V in by R1 by a current source I in. Okay, so what is output voltage equation coming? V naught is equal to minus I in times of RF. Okay, so I2V converter means the input is a current source. So what is the output you are getting? Output is a voltage. Voltage is equal to V is equal to I dot R. So output voltage is how much? Minus I in times RF. So how much will be the output voltage? The amount of input current dot RF is the output voltage, and it's inverting amplifier. So the output voltage is minus and plus, that is the output is in 180 degree out of phase with respect to the input. So how did we get this equation? Based on ideal gain equation of an inverting amplifier, V naught is equal to minus RF by R1. On multiplying V in on this side, we'll get V naught is equal to minus I in RF. What are the applications of this current to voltage converter? For sensing current from photodetectors, digital to analog converter. How did we get this circuit? So we have replaced the resistor R1 and V in by a current source I in. The current, the circuit converts the input current I in into a proportional output voltage. So what is the output voltage we are getting? V naught is equal to minus I in dot RF. So we can say V naught is proportional to I in. So this is current to voltage converter. It's an application of inverting amplifier. Now coming to the application of non-inverting amplifier with feedback is voltage follower. Okay, voltage follower. Voltage follower, other name is non-inverting buffer, are also known as unity gain amplifier. Voltage amplifier is an application of non-inverting amplifier with feedback. Okay, so here it is a non-inverting amplifier because the input V in is connected to plus or non-inverting terminal of the op amp, and the feedback circuit comprising of R1 and RF are connected to minus terminal or inverting terminal of the op amp. This is a non-inverting amplifier with feedback. Non-inverting because input is at the non-inverting terminal and there is a feedback. So it's a non-inverting amplifier with feedback. We have to transform this non-inverting amplifier to a voltage follower. For that, what is done? The resistor R1 and RF are modified in this way. So there is a direct connection from output back to the input. This is a voltage follower circuit. So this circuit is modified to this one. Okay, so RF is short circuited and R1 is open circuited. So it becomes a direct connection. Okay, so it's a non-inverting amplifier and there is a direct connection. So it's a voltage follower and output is plus minus. Output is in same phase with the input voltage. When there is a direct connection between output back to the input, what happens? Output voltage becomes equal to input voltage. Hence, it is a voltage follower. Voltage follower means the output voltage is following the input voltage. Okay, due to this feedback path. So to obtain the voltage follower from non-inverting amplifier with feedback, open R1 and short RF. How to derive the equation now? This equation V0 is equal to Vin. For that, we have to write the ideal voltage gain of an inverting amplifier with feedback. So gain equation with feedback is AF. AF is equal to V0 by Vin. For a non-inverting amplifier, it is 1 plus RF by R1. So what we have done to this RF? Here we have made RF 0, short circuited. So what will happen now? It will become, this complete term will become 0. So V0 by Vin will become 1. On cross multiplying, we can write V0 is equal to Vin. The output voltage is proportional to input voltage. So there are few important points to be noted here. The output voltage follows the input voltage. Voltage follower does not provide any amplification because the voltage gain is 1. We have seen here the voltage gain is 1. It provides isolation between output and input, that is, it acts as a buffer. So voltage follower means V naught is same as input voltage. Output voltage is following the input voltage. It means the gain is 1. So it does not provide any amplification, but is used for isolation between output and input. So it is used as a buffer. When non-inverting amplifier is configured for unity gain, it is called voltage follower. When non-inverting amplifier is configured for unity gain, it is called voltage follower because the output voltage is equal to and in phase with the input voltage. Output voltage is in phase and is equal to the input voltage. It is a non-inverting buffer because when placed between two networks, it removes the loading on the first network. So these are the few important points regarding voltage follower. I hope you have understood the voltage follower. Okay, so in this class we have discussed basics of operational amplifiers, as well as we have derived the open loop gain and closed loop gain of inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier. As well, we have seen what are the applications of inverting amplifier with feedback, which is I to V converter, current to voltage converter, and non-inverting amplifier with feedback application is voltage follower, where the output voltage V naught is coming same as the input voltage. So block diagram of operational amplifier, definition of operational amplifier, schematic symbol, pin diagram, equivalent circuit, voltage transfer curve, characteristics of op amp, idle characteristics of op amp, open loop op amp, closed loop op amp, need of closed loop op amp, and the gain derivations are covered in this class. I hope you have understood the class. If you have any queries, you can post in the comment section. Thank you. Good luck, students.